begin at the end. Time will buckle and bend.
It began because you died. Out of your cell you ran and then you died. You paused to catch your breath and die another gruesome death. So now you creep around each corner terrified. Humanity restored and then you died. A graveyard to explore, ha ha, denied. For every step you take is just one more fatal mistake. So you must learn to take the torture in your stride. Bells chime, torment, darkest descent, every soul spent to doom sent. Down in the depths of the dead, feel the agony, scars from a thousand wounds in your memory. Over and over, grind through the butchery, once more you run this gauntlet of misery. Sun's rays, behold and offer grace. Look to the sun's rays, comfort in the glow. Brave you may be, you think that your mind is tough. Come have a go if you think you're hard enough. Dive into death, embrace all the treachery. Learn to enjoy the bloodshed and butchery. Bells chime, torment,
Good morning, friends, and welcome to another painting stream. It's Finishing Friday! We're here, Finishing Friday, and I don't know if I'm going to have time to finish this figure. So this week, I have been working on a throwback Space Marine, which you can't see because it's completely obscured by the bright night light there, and it's tiny. This is a interesting challenge for me. Good morning, Lobster. In that I have never painted anything quite so small, and I've been doing a lot of intricate detail. So let's pop over to Zoom Cam. As I have mentioned and have shown on stream, this fellow is much smaller than Space Marines of today, which means that he's been a bit of a challenge to get the paint onto, just in terms of scale. We did some very, very fine detail, intricate work. We put this logo on last week that is hand-painted, just free-handed on there. So we've got the White Scar chapter logo. We've got this shoulder done. His face is looking good. Need to do some work on the gun and his hands and stuff. So, let's think about what we want to finish today. I don't have any more super, super fine detail. We're going to do his kneecap here. The kneecap indicates what squad he's a member of. I think we've decided on 6th squad. And then his left leg here also gets some detail that determines his company. I think we're going to do 3rd or 7th company. Probably 7th company. So that's going to be a little bit more detail. And then there's his backpack, which we haven't even touched yet. So for his backpack, I'm going to attempt a chrome non-metallic metal. So we'll see how that comes out. Not on the whole thing, just on portions of it. And then there's the base. I have a very rudimentary base put together here, you can see. I put a little skull on, because I can't resist the temptation to put skulls on bases. I chose an alien skull because with the scale of this guy, a human skull would look really weird and large. This is just from the Games Workshop skull box. Citadel skulls. So I put an alien skull there, figuring if the scale is weird, that's fine because it's an alien. And then we're going to do some texturing and detailing on the base. I don't know if we're going to finish this today. It's a lot. It's a lot to do. So, we will see. Gamer Dad, thank you for joining. It's good to see you. I have really enjoyed watching some of your streams. So, good to have you here. Early on this Friday morning here in New England, we are anticipating a blizzard tomorrow. So, hey, I might get some time to do some painting tomorrow if work gets called off. It's awkward in that the snow is anticipated to run all the way through Saturday, so it starts in the morning, runs through the day, and ends sometime around midnight on Saturday night, and it's going to be massive amounts of snow and wind and just nasty out there. There might not be that much snow on the road in the morning when I would be headed to work, but then getting back from work would be very difficult because I don't get out until 6 o'clock on Saturdays, and not super enthused. Also, Saturday is my last day before my vacation, so I don't want to have to go to work tomorrow. So maybe I call out and hang out with you folks and do some painting. We'll see. Throwback Marine, fun to do. So I'm gonna just dive in. We're gonna see how much we can get done today. Just in terms of detail. I think we'll start with the legs. So we're doing deck tan is our primary white color that we're using. And Vallejo 926 red is the primary red that we're using, and then adding other shades on top of those. So we'll start in with the deck tan. Like I said, I'm not optimistic that I'm going to finish this guy today. There's a lot to do. But I don't really have anything as complex as doing the logo on the shoulder there. So we will see what we will see. Getting the base coat done is definitely happening today. So it's not that much left of it. It's just a little bit here and there. This is my first time with a lot of this model. So, there's a lot of details in here I haven't had a chance to play with before. I thought about sculpting him a breech clout and doing something cool with that, and then decided against it. So I'm not really super familiar with this model. I've painted Space Marines, obviously, but I've only really painted modern day Space Marines. So I'm not as intimately familiar with the sculpt. This is a throwback. This is a Space Marine from 1993, so he is a different beast altogether. Gonna have to have some shading in here to differentiate between various parts. This is just a lot of white in this scheme that I've chosen to do. I'm doing a white scar paint scheme, and it's just huge swaths of blinding white. So a lot of the detail comes from the edges and stuff. So Chad, if you haven't followed him already, because I've talked about him on Twitter, you should check out Gamer Dad. because he has a very chill stream. And he's a talented painter. Fun to watch him at work. One thing I do want to avoid is painting over some of the joins in the armor, like I just did there. Because we don't want this. There, I fixed it. Apartment, mourning the fact that I am not with her right now. She's actually more concerned that Amanda's not home. Whenever my wife isn't home, our cat is very upset. So like I said, this is going to be quick work, just getting a base coat in on the bits of the armor that I haven't hit yet. We'll do more shading and stuff in a little bit. I want to get this base coat done so that I can... I've got so much to do today. It's finishing Friday. And here we see... biggest problem with painting in white, which is that you get a lot of brush strokes in the paint. I can thin it a little bit, but if I thin it, I lose precision, and the paint can go into crevices that I don't want it getting into, especially right here where I'm trying to keep clean, sharp edges. For anybody joining me from Gamer Dad's Discord, which is where I posted, which is why he is here, I should point out, I am strictly an amateur painter. This stream is not about teaching folks how to be better painters. It is about me pushing my boundaries and trying to do paint accomplishments that I am not confident in. I frequently set myself goals that I don't know if I can achieve. Because that's how you learn, right? That's how you become better as a painter. And that's why I'm doing this project. I'm doing this as part of a throwback painting event that I'm participating in, where the goal is to find a figure that is more than 20 years old and paint it. The figure I was given, this was given to me by my friend Derek, is this monopose Space Marine from the 1993 Space Marine starter box. Had orcs and Space Marines in it. Those 1993 orcs are also hilarious. They are such a... they're the squat, sort of... stubby orcs of old. I don't have any of those to show you, but if you Google it, you can see them. Here's a question. Do I paint his drawers white? his pants. I'm gonna leave them black. Leave that up to the viewer's imagination. I'm gonna thin this a little bit. Just to try and get fewer brush strokes in the paint. So amongst my goals for today, I talked about this at the top of the stream. We want to finish work on his armor. We want to do his kneecap and leg detail, because his leg is going to have his squad insignia on it. So we want to do that. This kneecap here, his left kneecap, is going to have an insignia on it as well. So I want to get those done. I have to put some paint on his base. That done. Have to work on some of the stuff on his belt. See, here is where things get ugly. Right in here, where it's white on white on white. There's like his arm, this little piece of his armor here, and then his leg, and they're all the same shade of white. So I'm gonna have to go in and do some detailing on those. Just to differentiate between them. But that is a task for slightly later in the stream. First, got to finish getting all this, his legs painted. Base coats first, details second. Always, always disappointed in my base coats. You get the base coat done and you look at it and you're like, oh, it looks so basic. It looks so frustratingly vague. I've got some dust in the paint here. Don't like that. It's from the base construction. I attempted to make him a plinth out of insulation foam. That was something I did off stream yesterday. It didn't go super well, chat. So, but it did make a mess. So I've got some leftover dust from that around my painting. You'll notice this is not a Space Marine base. This is a base from a D&D mini. I didn't have any 25mm Space Marine bases. I've got tons of 32mm bases. I've got scenic bases. I've got regular bases, but no 25mm, and the GW web store is currently sold out of 25mm bases. That's poor timing for me. Painting in white is just really challenging. which I knew going into this. The last thing I painted before this was a squad of Black Templars, where I tried to make their shoulder pads as brilliant white as I could, and the result obviously was I ended up having to spend a lot of time on those shoulder pads. I'm spending less time on this mini. I don't want to spend weeks on him, so I'm trying to get him done mostly in just a couple of days. We definitely learned that painting a brilliant white is a challenge. This is why this white shade that I'm using here, this off-white, or this is deck tan, one of my favorite shades of white to work in because it's a very dark shade and it gets really good coverage. I mean, you can see the brush strokes, obviously, but it's not as difficult to work in. This was actually some of the first advice that I got when I started painting, because I started with Tao. This was a couple years back. And obviously, or perhaps not obviously, but fortuitously for me, the new Tao Codex is about to drop. But let's look at one of my first minis. This is one of my first minis here. So I started with Tau, and the first piece of advice I was given when I started painting was, if you're going to paint white, don't paint white. Paint gray or light blue. Paint anything but white. So, for a base coat, that's why we're using this deck tan. It gives you the ability to go brighter if you need to go brighter, go darker if you need to go darker. It gives you more options for shading. As we'll see when we get to shading in a little bit. You can see definitely here I've done some shading on the shoulder. And then look at the gun, how just bland it is. Just a single color. Nothing interesting going on there. Some contrast to help the model along. Come in with some dark gray and a little bit on these joints in the legs, just to highlight the sculpt, because there are actually sort of crenellations, sort of wrinkles in the joints. I wonder if when a space marine walks, it sounds like one of those folding straws. It's the constant popping of these seams. I think we can all agree that space marines are not built for stealth. They're definitely loud, chonky boys. Variations of white. Right now, we've got just a vast sea of white going on here. It's not very appealing. See that I might have gone slightly overboard with the glue on this base. It's fine because I'm going to cover all that up. This mini, when I received him, was caked in paint. Like it was bad chat. I think I posted to my Instagram and Discord all the pictures of the disaster that was this paint job. I went in and stripped all the paint, obviously. I think that prior to that, he had been used as a piece of terrain, that he was painted as a statue or something like that, and had been used, you know, at the top of arch or a plinth, something of that nature, and that's why he was caked in blue and white and sort of gray paint. And his feet had just masses of glue on the bottoms. I had to really attack it with a hobby knife, sort of chip it away so that I could get him onto this base here. Oh, let's not forget, he's got his little space marine notch there. We'll highlight it later, but let's not forget it's there. Okay. Almost done with the base coat on one leg. Then we'll finish the base coat on the other leg. Then we have to wait for those base coats to dry before I can do the red insignia detail that I want to do. Look how many brush strokes I'm putting in here. Oh my gosh. This is working in white paint, chat. That's what you get. So I've thinned down the paint a little. And this is just a second coat that's much thinner. And hopefully obscures some of those brushstrokes. I am going to be painting red over a lot of this, so it doesn't have to look perfect. Also see the paint getting up into the bristles of my brush. That's worrisome as well. I don't want to ruin my new brushes. These are some nice synthetic brushes that I bought just last week, or I received last week. I bought them a couple weeks ago from Rosemary and Company, and they are very nice brushes. Oops. And exceptionally affordable. So I'm quite pleased with them for the price that I paid for them. They're really, really good. I just want to make sure that I don't destroy them, which means don't let the paint get up into the ferrule and spread the bristles, which is what paint likes to do. Paint may be your ally, also be your adversary. A worthy foe. Bits of leg. At the very end, I will be adding some color to this. Weathering when we reach the end of this project, which might be today. Might actually be today. Finish these legs, this base coat for these legs, and then while we wait for them to dry so that we can put on the insignia and stuff, we're going to work on his belt, and I want to work on the, trying not to completely fill this notch. Work on his belt, and we'll work on this skull. need chat. Coffee. Definitely a 4 cup of coffee day. Oh, yeah. That's the stuff. Supposedly there's officially blizzard warnings in my area now, which means they're going to recommend only emergency vehicles be on the roads tomorrow. Have I mentioned today that the scale of this thing is really strange to me? I'm sure for people who started this hobby in the 90s, you know, this is what they were painting back in the day. But for me, who's only been painting for a couple of years, just not used to working at this scale. If I was working in any color other than white, I'd probably be done with these legs already. Just the fact that this is white and requires multiple coats and thinning down and being so careful not to get brush strokes into the paint job. Dust motes look right here. It's just a clump of dust there. It's annoying. Oh well. It's okay, Chad. Means I'd prefer it if it was a smooth surface, but you can't have everything you want. All right, let's finish this chat. And then we can move on to something else. Enjoying having some big giant circles in my streaming mix now. frequently listen to this at work as well. Just a fan of the chiptunes. Legs for now. And we'll move on to something else and then come back to them in a few minutes. Let's get them minutes to dry. More paint on the model now than when I started today, and that is sometimes all you can hope for. Okay. So let's do this. Skull boy. Tempted to paint a notch on the front of his legs. Just so anybody who has watched for a while or is familiar with 40K minis knows that Space Marines have these notches, like these ones right here on the backs of his leg. They're normally under the kneecap in the front. Let's see if I've got an example here. I don't really. So I could attempt to paint that in, but I'm not going to bother today, I think. Let's get that skull quickly. It should be much faster for the skull. We're using Morden bone. So chat, you will all know how much I love the Citadel Skulls box. I use that thing for my base detailing constantly. Because skulls are cool. So I was a little bit worried I wouldn't be able to attach a skull to the base for this mini because of the scale problem. Because if I did a human skull, it would be enormous. You can see how large this skull is. This is slightly larger than a human skull from this box. but a human skull, if you looked at it on the base here, it would be apparent that a human skull would not fit inside that helmet. And I didn't want that contrast to be too glaring. So that's why I chose an alien skull. Okay. Once this is done, we'll work on his belt. That should be quick. Today, because that's the piece that I am least confident in. I am planning just getting some of this out onto my palette, thinning it a little bit. I'm planning to attempt some NMM chrome on the backpack. My skills with non-metallic metal are not great. Of it. Alright, that's enough for that skull for now. I'm gonna get some very light brown for the horn. Got some khaki. This is from one of the Whiz Kids paint collections. That's not quite the color I'm looking for. Let's see if I've got some cork brown. Let's try this. Circumstance where I actually don't mind if the brush strokes are apparent as long as they go in the right direction. Because it'll reinforce the sort of bony look for this horn. On this and some dry brushing to give it some life. Now the challenge for the remainder of today is to not hold the model by this horn. Thank you. start working on his belt. I'm going to use a couple of different browns here. I've got my flat brown somewhere. For the dark areas of the belt that are up around his waist, which you can't even see because they're underneath his gun here, but you know me. I like to try and get details that you can't see. Just a hint of color in there. He's got his holster and a knife on his belt. We're going to do those in a red leather 818 here. And of course we'll be adding a lot more to this later. Here. One of the downsides of doing white as the primary color for this model is that I'm not going to be doing a wash on a lot of him. We all know that a wash can cover any number of sins. In the absence of a wash, I have to be very careful about my edges. I will be doing a wash on the scabbard. So these areas will get a wash just on the leather. Before we do any shading on the legs, let's do those logos that we need to do, those emblems. Sort of the next step. some shading, some highlighting, and we'll work on that backpack. Making good progress here. Butt of a pistol sticking out here. What color should that be? Think about that. Perhaps just a different shade of brown. It's looking pretty good, I think. Brush strokes here, but I don't think I care. We're going to give that a worn leather feeling with a wash and some highlights later. I'm going to add a little bit of white on the backpack, just in a couple areas. So this backpack, very, very different from a modern Space Marine's backpack. So I am not as familiar with this sculpt and have to sort of make it up as I go along. I'll admit I have not done much research. I haven't looked at a lot of classic Space Marine paint jobs to see how other people have done this. Just sort of diving in and doing it how I think I would have done it back in the day. some of these areas are going to be sort of metallic, and some of them are sort of rubbery, and some of them are the same color as his base armor. So we've got these hoses here on the sides that we're going to leave primed in black and add some highlights to, just like the hoses on his helmet. And then we've got all the nozzles, which we're going to do sort of a metallic thing, and then we've got this weird-ass hole in the middle of his backpack. Modern Space Marines have a sort of hubcap there. Done with this, it's back to red and doing the logo or the emblems. Also got this sort of vent on the front of the backpack right here, and I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with that. I actually was thinking maybe of making it a light source. So chat, we are about halfway through today's stream, and made some progress. This gap cleaner. might spend some time trying to clean up the mold lines and stuff. Right here, this mold line was really, really bad. I think the mold was not fully aligned when this was molded back in the 90s. Looks a little better now. Get the other side, and then we'll go back to work on the legs. When I was contemplating what paint scheme to use for this guy, I sort of tried to make a determination of what would be the coolest look. Bunch of different Space Marine chapters, and I was like, I realize I am dooming myself by saying this, but I really like the White Scar paint scheme. Just the contrasts of the whites and reds. It looks cool. And that's my ultimate arbiter. What I do, often to my own detriment, when I'm deciding how to build my units for an army, I spend a lot more time thinking about what would look cool than what would be an effective army in battle. I don't play the game very much, mostly just paint. This is the last bit of white base coat I'm going to be doing on this figure. It's a good feeling. Back to the legs now. Now that we've got some paint on the backpack. Oh, I missed some bits. nozzles on the side. Progress. Obviously gonna have to do a lot more work on that backpack, but we are in a good place now with the white base coat on everything. Let's get those legs done. So back to our paint scheme. I'm basing this on what's easiest to do, so we're gonna do sixth squad, or should I do second squad? What do you think, chat? Is this cooler? Or is that cooler? Yeah, I think I'm gonna do sixth squad. Red. Again, just Vallejo 926. This is a great, great color. Have a little coffee. I might take a brief break after we finish getting these logos on. This mostly because it's the easiest. I'm not feeling super steady-handed today. Thank you. That looks pretty good. Might be a little bit too far to the left, but it's okay. And then I'm gonna do seventh company. It was a mistake to put this skull here. I'm having to paint around it now. So what we can't see from this angle here is what happens to this paint on the back side of the leg. Assume there's a similar lightning bolt pattern on the back. What do you folks think? Get to make it up myself. So that is most of the base coat done. do work on the backpack. But we're pretty much there. In terms of detail and base coat. So now, I'm gonna take a short break, get myself fresh coffee. Back in a couple of moments. And when I return, we'll start working on some highlights. And some washes and such. Actually, I think I'll do a quick wash. Let's get this phone out of the way. I'm going to do a quick wash on the holster and the knife on his belt. Skull while I'm at it. Yes, thank you, Lobster, for the coffee alert. Coffee. So I'm just going to do a quick Agrax Earthshade. Wash in a couple of places. Not using my nice brush for this. Trying to preserve that brush. As well. Being quite liberal with this because I don't. This doesn't have to look pretty because it's a piece of base detailing. And in fact, you kind of want it to fade a little bit. You don't want it to pull too much attention. well sculpted into these. Here. And then I'm going to take a short break. Like I said, get myself some more coffee. And when I return, we're going to work on some highlights. We are actually getting close, chat. I mean, right now it's mostly base coat that we've done today, and base coat always looks crappy, so it's fine that it looks rough. It's in the detail that things really come to life. Short break. I will be right back, and we will continue work on this little boy here.
Brow from the shining mountains to the fiery isles, with a wink and a smile, blinded by my light. Bigger in my hands, victorious in the fight. Break the blessed and the damned. Watch out, because I'm tearing through. The world is turning black and blue. Bursting with color, I spin. I'm gliding on a wave of grace. I'm riding, don't you break my pace. Passing flowers everywhere, this butterfly. Boom! Got a fist of power, you can fight me, but you can't close these eyes. Blinded by my light, bigger in my hands, the joy is in the fight. Break the blessed and the damned. Watch out, because I don't hold back. Never crack.
chat, I'm back. All right. Hope everybody had a nice stretch. I got myself some coffee, stretched my back out a little bit. And now, we're getting close. We're getting close. So we need to do a fair amount of shading here. Right now, he looks kind of basic. You can see what I did on the shoulders. We're going to try and carry a lot of that into the rest of the model now. And this is going to involve a little bit of blending and a couple different colors. So we've got off-white is our very, very bright white. We've got deck tan is our middle color. That's the base coat that we did everything in. And then we're using Stonewall Gray as our darker color. And then on the belt, we're going to use some Cork Brown and some Flat Brown to add a little bit more color in there. So yeah, it's all just shading now. For the red, we're going to add in a little bit of scarlet highlight. So let's get out some paints, get them on the palette. Maybe do a little bit of blending, a little bit of dry brushing. Just doing what we can to make this model come to life. Start with some dry brushing on his belt. It's going to be fast and easy. I'm going to be doing two different colors of dry brushing in here. Kind of doing highlights and lowlights. Should be pretty quick. Oops, that went on a little darker than I intended. Well, lighter, but you get the idea. You just don't want anything to be a single color. It's boring. So I'm trying to do a little bit of quick work to make it less dull. edges of the model, you know, try and give it some detail. Not super exciting, but it's something. Maybe just a little bit more of an edge over here. That'll do. It's rough, but that's fine. All right. Switch brushes. And let's... Actually, maybe... Maybe I continue to use the dry brush for some of these edges. I'm getting the darker brown now, or darker gray. And we're just gonna try and add in some shadow. Subtle work. It's not super obvious immediately. But it adds texture. I don't want this to be too painted on while I'm trying to dry brush it in. I don't want it to be just harsh shadows. Whoop! Getting a little bit on the sole of his boot there, that's fine. notch there, but I think we'll use a better brush for that. All right, so that's some of the sort of low lights done. Going pretty quick here. So this is not... I'm not agonizing about this. Some highlights. Let's do some highlights first. So for this we're using off-white, which is a very, very bright white. I don't know. I feel like this is really rough. But I'm trying not to spend all day on this. Basically trying to catch edges and bring some life to the model. That in. We can do a little bit more precision now with another brush. Just throw the model. Okay. Just want to get a little teensy bit more white on the back of this leg here. Switch brushes. And we're going to try and get a little more precision in some of the edges here. I don't know if that's working. It's fine. Okay. Now I need an even finer brush. And then we'll work on the backpack a little bit before we get some color on the base. sure this is working quite the way I wanted it to. But, yeah. Chat, I think we did not finish for Finishing Friday, but we made some significant progress. I want to do more work on this backpack. We're going to try and do a sort of a chrome NMM look to that. So that is our next big chore. But it is now noon. I want to add a little bit of bright red to some of the bits I did on the legs today. And then we're going to call it a day for today. Oh, and I want to add the color to the base. So, on the legs here. Just a little dash of color to give this some depth. That I wanted right there. That's fine. You can tone it down. Always paint over stuff, right, chat? made a lot of progress today, chat. Just remember how much of this was just bare at the start of today's stream? And see how much less of it is bare plastic now. Of light to the skull. It's going on much darker than I wanted it. It's fine. And as a last detail for today, we're going to add the base texture. We'll finish the backpack and the other highlights and stuff on the gun in our next session. So we didn't finish for Finishing Friday, but we got really darn close. For the base texture, we're using Martian Iron Earth. This is great stuff. You put it on, just sort of slather it on there, and then it cracks as it dries. So it'll have some nice texture to it by the time it's done. Close, chat. Really darn close to done. Just pretty much the backpack to go. That shouldn't too long, so it probably won't be a full stream to complete it. I'm not anticipating it being a full stream. At some point over this weekend, we'll do a partial stream with the goal of adding a little bit more texture to this base. And adding a little bit more weathering and stuff on the model, and doing that backpack where we're gonna try to do sort of chrome NMM look. But in the meantime, I'm pretty happy with the results that we have achieved so far. Model is looking very, very cool. It's just exactly what I wanted to be able to do. I feel like I've learned some in the process of doing it, which is always the way, right? You learn as you go. This Martian iron crust is not going to go on properly unless I really slather it on, so I need to put a little extra in. The whole point of it is that as it dries, it pulls back and crackles and looks cool. Of this dune that I've sculpted. Just want gobs and gobs of it around there. So chat, I'm going to wrap up for today. I may stream tomorrow, it depends on the weather somewhat, what we're going to be able to do. Thank you so much for joining me today. Thanks again to Gamer Dad for popping into the chat to say hello. Thank you to anybody who is watching the YouTube archive or the VOD. I appreciate you as well. things up for today. Spectacular progress, chat. Spectacular progress. Ah, lovely. Now we just wait for that Martian iron crust to do its thing. Still have work to do on the backpack, the gun, a couple other areas that still need attention, but we are really, 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 really close. So very close with this. So I will possibly see you folks, like Lobster says, tonight in Amanda's chat. My wife will be reading From Snuff by Terry Pratchett. Over at her chat, Merriman Lion. And in the meantime, I'm going to go get myself some lunch. I will see you folks again soon. Wish me luck with the blizzard tomorrow. Be excellent to each other, friends, and enjoy whatever art it is you choose to do. I'll see you again soon. Bye, everyone.